Hello everyone, my name is Engineer Arjun Singh and today we are going to see some concepts of structural engineering as a part of our structural engineering lectures. Today we will learn about the advanced construction materials which are being used worldwide and what are the materials which increase the efficiency of the structure and reduce the cost of the structure, also reduce the time period of construction. So let's begin, starting from concrete. Concrete is a very important and a very major construction material used. Concrete is now being enhanced and being improved by inducing last reinforced fibers into it, nanoparticles. These act as a secondary reinforcement to the structure. This I have told in my previous lectures also. So these type of enhancements and these types of addition in the concretes add a particular strength to the concrete. The concrete is good in tension but is weak in compression, so it increases the tensile part of the concrete. Now going further on, we have different kinds of bricks, or we must say that we have a different kind of blocks that are being used in the industry. First we used to have the conventional old bricks, then we moved on to the fly ash bricks, then now we have the AAC bricks, auto caved aerated blocks. So these are the blocks which are being used in one of the finest construction projects, because these are lightweight blocks, easy to transport. They don't require so much of mortar or so much of binding material to bind them, so it reduces the cost of the structure of the wall also, and it gives a smooth finish to the wall, so not a much of a plaster is required to provide a good finish to the wall. So this is a very good construction technique which is being used. In concrete also we have various kinds of porous concrete, self-heating concrete, which are being used at different locations depending upon their requirement and the situation and the climatic conditions of that area. Now moving further on, we have reinforcement or reinforcement bars. That first we used to have the HYSD steel bars. Now we moved on to the TMT bars. You must have been aware of these bars. First we used to have the FE415, now we have moved to the FE500. Now these kinds of bars are basically used in today's scenario. It is being adopted everywhere, and it is being prescribed, and it is being advised by the structural engineers also in the industry. Now our next topic is cement. So we have different kind of cements depending upon different kinds of situation that in which situation the cement is to be required, and in which situation the cement performs well, like rapid hardening cements, sulfate resistant attack cements. So these are the different kinds of cements which are being used. So basically the purpose of this cement depends upon the location of the project. Say if I am constructing a footing at a soil which has a high sulfate content, and I want to resist my concrete and my bars from the sulfate attack, so I will use a sulfate resistant cement, and depending on other situation I will use a different kind of cement. So these are the different situations in which different cements can be used. So thank you everyone for watching. Hope you like it.